Subscribe to Simplified Biology channel and press the bell icon to get notified when a new video is uploaded. Hello friends, welcome to Simplified Biology. We'll continue with pituitary gland. Today's topic is anterior pituitary hormones. Pituitary gland can be divided into two parts, the anterior lobe and the posterior lobe. Anterior lobe forms the anterior pituitary, while the posterior lobe forms the posterior pituitary. The anterior lobe produces and releases hormones, while the posterior lobe stores and releases hormones produced by the hypothalamus. Now this is the larger one is the anterior lobe, while the smaller one is the posterior pituitary. The anterior pituitary consists of three parts, pars tubularis. Now this is pars tubularis, pars intermedia, this one, and this is pars distalis. Anterior pituitary is connected to the hypothalamus through hypophyseal portal vessels. Now this is hypothalamus, this is the anterior pituitary, and this is the infundibulum. These are the hypothalamus hypophyseal portal vessels that connect the hypothalamus to the anterior pituitary. Now through these vessels, regulatory hormones that are formed by the hypothalamus are passed to the anterior pituitary. So through the hypophyseal portal vessels, the regulatory hormones produced by the hypothalamus are passed or transferred to the anterior pituitary. These hormones regulate and coordinate the anterior lobe to produce or stop production of specific hormones. So upon receiving signal from the hypothalamus, the anterior pituitary stimulates its cells to secrete hormones. The anterior pituitary consists of five principal types of cells: the somatotrophs, thyrotrophs, corticotrophs, lactotrophs, and gonadotrophs. Somatotrophs forms the growth hormone, which is a polypeptide. Thyrotrophs form the thyroid stimulating hormone, that is TSH, which is a glycoprotein. Corticotrophs forms ACTH, that is adrenocorticotropic hormone, which is also a polypeptide, and it also forms MSH, that is melanocyte stimulating hormone. Lactotrophs forms prolactin, which is also a polypeptide, while gonadotrophs form FSH, that is follicle stimulating hormones, and LH, that is luteinizing hormones. Now these are glycoproteins. So let's start with growth hormone, also known as somatotropin. Growth hormone is responsible for growth and metabolism. Now in growth, it promotes bone elongation, growth of muscles and cartilage, and even growth of body cells. While it stimulates protein synthesis and inhibits its breakdown, means it is responsible for protein anabolism. It causes hydrolysis or breakdown of fat. That is, this is also known as lipolysis. And it reduces uptake of blood glucose for ATP production, as fat is used for energy. So growth hormones aids in healthy bone and muscle mass and affects fat distribution. Thyroid stimulating hormone, or TSH, it controls growth and activity of the thyroid gland. It influences uptake of iodine and synthesis of thyroid hormones like thyroxine by the thyroid gland. Next, adrenocorticotropic hormone, also known as ACTH or the corticotropin. It stimulates the adrenal cortex to secrete its steroid hormones, that is glucocorticoids. Follicle stimulating hormones, or FSH. These are secreted in both males and females. In males, they stimulate spermatogenesis, that is formation of sperms, and are also responsible for normal functioning of seminiferous tubule. While in female, they stimulate oogenesis, that is egg formation, and is also responsible for development of graafian follicle in ovary, which secretes estrogen. Luteinizing hormone, also referred as interstitial cell stimulating hormone. In female, this stimulates ovulation and forms corpus luteum that secretes progesterone. In male, they are referred as interstitial cell stimulating hormones. It affects the Leydig cells or the interstitial cells of the testis and stimulates secretion of testosterone. FSH, that is follicle stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone are together referred as gonadotropic hormones. They act in a combined form, means they are referred as synergistic hormones, as they together act, and they ensure the normal functioning of ovary and testis. Next, prolactin, also known as mammotropin hormone or luteotropic hormone. They cause growth of mammary glands during pregnancy and are responsible for lactation after delivery in women. They suppress the release of gonadotropin, due to which ovulation is inhibited and the ovaries become inactive. And last, melanocyte stimulating hormone, which is secreted by the middle lobe, that is pars intermedia. They stimulate melanocytes to synthesize melanin, the pigment. They are found in all vertebrates, but are more effective in the lower vertebrates like rats or rodents. They darken skin by distributing the melanin pigment. Hormones of the anterior pituitary can be remembered by the mnemonic flat pig, where F is FSH, L is LH, A is ACTH, and T is TSH. P of pig is for prolactin, and G is for growth hormone, GH. Now, the hormones of flat, that is FSH, LH, ACTH, and TSH, are tropic hormones. Means they stimulate other endocrine glands to secrete hormones, while prolactin and GH are direct hormones. That's all for today. Please do like, subscribe, and comment, and also visit our website by clicking on the link given below. Thank you for watching.